So today we're just going basically do four recipes. Maybe we will do a chicken quesadilla today toward the end of the class, and you can all taste it. A protein powder drink or a smoothie, if you want to call it this way, and that one has a lot of boosting energy for, because you are all students, so you need to keep your stamina and your endurance and your mental capabilities, and so that's what I'm going to show you. And then also the dessert is excessively easy to do and delicious and has no sugar. So we're going to start with the protein powder today. And would someone read the recipe to me or check the ingredients or so I don't forget anything?
Almond butter, 2 tablespoons of almond butter.
Yeah.
Greek yogurt.
Okay. Give me a chance. Do you have it?
Almond butter.
Okay. Almond butter.
Banana, mango.
Okay. So this recipe is normally for it would definitely serve about 4 or 5 portions. So I'm not going to measure, I'm just going to put half of this, which is 16 ounces. In the second page of your little brochure pamphlet, you have a list of all the tools that you should get if you want to start the basic kitchen. So let's use 2 banana, but someone needs to cut it. When you use a cutting board, you have to always clean it in between things that you are doing. Contamination is going to be a major issue for your health when you cook. So you always clean in between your Greek yogurt and mango. This is so small, it's only, normally it's for like 3 or 4 serving. So we just press 1 orange. And then so we will put, probably we'll have to do a few batches. So this is more like a puree than a protein shake. So in order to make it as a shake, you just want to add a little liquid. So we're just putting some orange juice today. And or you can put some mango juice if you have. Half cup, right? But again, it's for basically 2 or 3 portions, so I'm doing for a little bit more people today. So obviously you can adjust it to what you like. That's okay. Alright, let me go on to something. It needs to be very, very small. Just with this seat as well. I'm using the same board because this is all going in the same. Normally, you want to clean it. So like I said, you do not need a lot of equipment in the kitchen. You just, however, you need a good knife. It doesn't have to be a huge knife or an expensive knife, but it has to cut well. And you need to take care of your knife. You need to always
I
put
prefer
away.
If you
I put some
do not use the electric mixer for the onions. So
transform the test.
Don't hold it like this.
But always the best is to use a knife.
Sharpen with your knife
and then do not
or your
use
knife.
It for anything else that very important. You close them.
So those mushrooms are done now.
We're going to use this pan and then just try that. And today we're not going to use some of the unnecessary things. I just want to use the two breasts and then just, you know, if your knife is good, it's kind of easy to follow. And then just, with my plate, I could almost tear it apart. But. And we're going to start the chicken, saute the chicken. One leg. Okay, if you look at the chicken, you can see there's a little lump here. This is the oyster. So that's the part that is so good.
So because we don't have too much time, I'm just going to cut the chicken in smaller pieces and make some stripe.
And then you want to open the chicken in the middle. Stay close to the spine.
One good thing to have at home is to buy a very inexpensive little thermometer
because you want to measure
temperature
of your chicken.
It's one of the most important things to do is that your temperature reach 165.
The reason I chose to show you this today is because it's more economical to buy a whole chicken than buy
so it's very
two breasts or four breasts.
Only a few dollars, but it's definitely really important.
And
so
you
start with the skin down.
Then you fresh chicken today on the stove. And then, so this could be put in a big pot and cover with water, and you could throw carrot and onion and celery, and you'll have a really good chicken. So that's so good. And then you will sell that, and you will actually look at the
we learn in my anatomy.
You have a need for this
learn about the muscles.
Yes.
And
so now it's kind of plastic, so now you can go around.
Mm-hmm. Okay, wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so I do want to cut through the bone.
Yeah, no, just stay, don't necessarily go close to the bone. Now, you can see where the leg is.
Yeah.
You see the bone here?
Mm-hmm.
So basically, you want that part here, right?
Yeah, let you finish the.
So you see now you have the bone here.
Mm-hmm.
So this is really what you want to cut here.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay, thank you. So right now, we're good.
Should
I
finish or does anyone
else?
Maybe. I finish? Okay.
So now,
remember, you want to do the first cut.
First cut.
Okay.
Right,
because I want to.
And then I
want to.
I do.
Because you added some lemon juice. Today we are not doing precision cutting. It's just like to show you how to separate them.
You would
because then you can want to put your
cellophane on
and then press it.
So
if
you work in a restaurant,
there's no space in between
precision cutting.
Avocado might turn around.
They probably, yeah, they do it
very fast.
So
when it comes to your
knife,
you can use it more like flat.
We are going to put it later on.
This is good here, so you can only use it this way instead of like this.
Right.
You get a bit grip. To do this.
Oh, I see.
So you do, and then you can see where you're going now.
Ah, okay. Thank you. Yeah, it's like, don't be, I think I get scared of using the
knife to its full capacity. That's already,
who knows,
spaced out. You know, you don't always think about how the whole thing fit together.
Right. And it's definitely less expensive.
Yeah.
To do this and
when
then
you
to use your entire
egg
when
you
instead
use
of
eggs.
When you buy the only the breast, you pay more money than for the whole thing.
You want to do that almost one at a time in
a little trouble breaking.
You want to check the quality. So in other words, if you have 10 eggs in one bowl and then you put 11 eggs, it's not good.
Yeah.
Then you are holding
you
all your
exercise.
Get my stand. Hand exercise.
It's a good idea to do individual egg check for quality. And also,
right.
If you have a little piece of hair, now it allows you to carcass remove it without this, struggling with the slamming of the egg. And this, the container is going to go this way. It's going to go in this one. So here's your small bowl, or you can have another prep bowl, if it's easier, bigger one.
So, okay.
You really want to have two.
Okay.
Always. So in here, I'll just show you the first one. So you do want to make a really fast pack in the middle of it. And
when you cook your chicken at home,
don't hesitate, don't
have
to just lean on
one.
Is it this? And then you
love the flavor, the chicken.
It also protects the chicken from burning.
No.
If it does burn, it protects the inside of the
chicken.
It's not nice to have it as a little skin. So when you want to separate your egg, egg yolk, with your pastry, or if you want to do egg white first, so you will do the same technique, you make one fast crack. And then as you cook, the white, let's say the white is going in here, so you want to be above the white, because that's where it's going. And then you want the white, and you want the white, tight, maybe then you can go to the yolk. So one, so just overwork it, but it's nice to cook.
Yeah.
So then you lean, yolk stays, and that's when you have a better perspective. And then you can go back and forth until all the white is in the bowl.
So the pan is warming up, and we're just going to saute the
so if you want to do flour
first.
So now for because
we're
doing
recipe,
we don't need
this.
We're just going to learn how to separate that.
And then so how do you tell if it's a good egg or a bad egg?
The color is nice, it's not
cloudy.
I like to use
grape seed oil because grape seed oil
does not
burn
easily.
But
it was easy
to
do
one
of
the
pieces of shell
to cook.
So
if you have a chance, you can.
Small pieces will cook faster, like this.
I don't cook like this.
A larger piece is not cooked yet.
You make it food.
So
you go
if you are kind of in a rush,
you can do that with a lot of salt.
Send small slices. This could be also called stir fry. And ideally you would want to have a big bowl, large bowl, so you can really whisk. This, if you whisk too hard in here, it's going to overflow.
So what you've done is your each plate, you will So if it's only you, you just want to do five of those. Put it in your blender. And here's the leg, so I'm just going to deboard it. It's very slippery, so we should really have 30 seconds. Remove the skin. For the leg, I'm taking the skin off. The leg is more fat, so we don't really need that yourself. As long as your plate is in front. So for the quesadilla, you want to have small pieces. You could use a blender if you wanted to, but it would be more like puree. Not very appealing. But it's totally suitable. So we do recommend to use a Teflon skillet for the eggs, always. This is the only time we use a Teflon. Normally they're more like purist. We don't like Teflon, but for the omelette, it's really the way to go. Otherwise, your eggs are going to burn and not going to be pretty. So we're going to use a little rapeseed oil today. Put it on high at first and reduce the temperature.
Has anybody else ever separated an egg?
Put some salt. Who knows how to do that? When you separate your eggs, when you use eggs in general, you always want to check. You want to do them almost one at a time in a little bowl because you want to check the quality. So in other words, if you have 10 eggs in one bowl, you would want to So you do want to make a really fast crack in the middle of it. And don't hesitate, you just one. And then you very gently.
So you can use a spatula.
And then you have to So when you want to separate your eggs, you do egg yolk or if you do pastry,
as you're holding
egg white first. You do the same technique. Now it's too high, so you want to lower.
And then the
white, let's say the white is going here, so you want to be above the white.
And keep an eye on it, and then you would see, and then you just very delicately you can go underneath and make the egg
roll
one. So just
be below the hole that you just made. So then your yolk stays in that pad. And then you can go back and forth until all the white is in the bowl. Mm-hmm. And then your yolk will go on the back.
So you want to do food? Sure.
So now because we're doing an omelette, we don't need it.
So you can just start the spoon. Chocolate powder.
So because we're splitting the recipe in two, so I'm just going to use 2 tablespoons for now. This is pure cocoa powder, so it's not sweetened. I'm just going to put a little salt on it and try to be strong. Okay. And then we will add 2 more as we are doing the second batch. And we need
Thank you.
don't have a thermometer. How can you tell a chicken to cook?
Well, then you can open it and just be sure it's not thin. Small pieces will cook faster, like those. They are cooked. The larger piece is not cooked yet. So if you are kind of in a rush, just cut small slices. Maybe another.
I have to do a little bit more there. So, but you can start toasting.
So I'm going to do one more batch, and then the chicken is basically going to do it. So
nice cook all around. Mm-hmm. So you can still see the difference. So I think you can find
when when I've made omelets, or the way I was taught was to add milk and such. I'm curious, like, what, you know, I don't know.
You add milk to your omelet?
Yeah. Yeah, if that's like a common, maybe, or where, if in France, it's, they don't add milk to omelets, so the tradition in France is just.
So, it's a good idea to have two pans when you do the quesadilla, so one can keep your chicken warm. And then the other one you use it just to simply to warm up your You don't need to put any oil or anything that. This is mostly like this. So it can just and you're spreading your warm chicken on one of them. So you go all the way to the end. So when you do that at home, you want to have the first tortilla
really when you
on your cutting board over the platter.
When you do that at home, you want to have the first tortilla on your cutting board or on a platter that you will bring to the center, because you're not moving this anymore. It's going to be two. So you just go with the chicken all the way to the edge. And you cover with guacamole.
As long as your hands are oily, it's fine to handle food. So I'm going to shred all this chicken now. And then we will just rewarm it very fast before serving. So you stay with the grain of the chicken. Makes it easier and more tender. You can also take it and shred it by hand like this. You can feel the fiber of the meat, the flesh. Cover with the other one, up to you. And then here's your quesadilla. Definitely what you want to do, you always want to have your finger in front of your blade. So like another one, don't put your hand flat, but put always your finger like this way, like hooked. And then you will never cut the tip of your finger. So you your first phalange is against your blade. And then you make little wedges. If you do that, remember, you won't cut yourself as long as your blade is in front. So for the quesadilla, you want to have small pieces. You could use a blender if you want it, but it would be more like puree. That's not very appealing. But it's storage will.
You can come and help yourself while it's still warm.
Who wants to do the omelet? We have to start this omelet now, so.
Thank you.
teflon skillet for the eggs, always. This is the only time we use a teflon. Normally we're more like a purist. We don't like teflon, but for the omelette, it's really the way to go. Otherwise, your eggs are going to burn every day, Sadia. So, again, we're going to use a little grapeseed oil today. Store it on high at first.
This is your homemade,
so it doesn't look like her. No, it's not as easy to eat. Maybe you can just use your fork and knife. But I'll show you another way to do it, the way you are more used to it,
you can
probably.
Tablespoon of grapeseed oil in the pan.
How is it? Used to it, so you just do basically the same, except you will fold it, so you only put it on half of it. So the pan is too small for all this quantity, so we're just going to split it. We could use a ladder, but we don't have one. But normally you would not have a recipient like this. You would have more like a prep bowl.
Is it spicy enough?
This can be put also. This could be
you
put
in
the more salt, pepper, jalapeno. It could be.
I have a question.
Okay, a crepe bowl, you said, is that just the place?
So the other way is this way,
texture,
traditional way. So you take fold it into.
Oh, you said crepe bowl.
That might be easier too.
No. Oh, no.
It's a crepe bowl, I think.
Oh, crepe bowl, I'm sorry. Okay. my bad.
So you probably need two of those. So very delicately, you would want to and so you're going to make this tonight?